internet trolls are people lurking in cyberspace who launch attacks against celebrities and ordinary people. They're often hidden behind fake names, and their comments can be tremendously damaging to reputations and egos. We saw some extreme examples of mean tweets on the U.S. late-night comedy talk show Jimmy Kimmel. Here's a clip of some celebrities on the Kimmel show reading out some insulting tweets they had received. Listen.
Celebrities with Twitter accounts, and I know this because I have one, get bombarded with sometimes hundreds of insults a day. So over the last few months, we've been asking some of our celebrity guests to sit down and read the mean things people tweet about them. This is the third time we've done this, and we call it Celebrities Read Mean Tweets.
Selena Gomez is on the radio right now. Is there a volume lower than mute? Sorry.
I saw Larry King at dinner, but it might have been just a run-of-the-mill goblin.
Dr. Phil, why don't you shut the f*** up, you bald-headed, big-mouth hillbilly?
Simon Cowell, you, my friend, are a d***. Actually, that's one of the nicest things anybody's ever said about me, and I've got a bit of a lump in my throat now, thank you, because I really am a d***.
All right, so what's the best way to respond to online harassment and internet trolls? Let's get some perspective from Howard Bragman. He's the founder of 15 Minutes, a public relations firm that specializes in consumer brands and celebrity image management. So he knows a lot about this Twitter and social media stuff, and he's in our New York bureau. Thanks for being with us.
Glad, and I'm also with Reputation.com, and we specialize in what happens online in your life, which is kind of scary, as you pointed out.
It is sometimes. Sometimes it's annoying. Sometimes it's hurtful. Sometimes it's harassment. I mean, occasionally I'll get some mean tweets sent to me, and my policy, and you tell me if I'm doing the right thing or not, okay? My policy is if it's just an insult, not a critique, not a comment, but just an insult, I block the user. Is that the way to do it?
That's a great way to start. I mean, number one rule, as I tell my celebrity clients, is develop a thick skin. You have to understand that almost all of these mean things that people post about you online are anonymous. So I call it really writing on a bathroom wall, and people realize that they have the power to talk to you directly. And you have to, number one, if you can, take that power away and block them. And I really encourage my celebrities not to read it. Particularly, I handle a lot of crises. And I encourage them not to read it because it's toxic. Even if you know it's garbage, it can really hurt you. You know, people are saying nasty things.
But why does it hurt you? I mean, here's a celebrity making millions of dollars a year, presumably. They have people around them. They're adored. They're photographed. They're in movies. They're in TV shows. And yet a little tweet from some anonymous person they've never met is going to hurt their feelings. People are going to say, boo-hoo.
I don't care who you are. We all have insecurities. And contrary to popular belief, many celebrities are actually human beings, okay?
Are they?
With real, yeah, I know, it's shocking. I've just broken news. But with real feelings. And this stuff can be hurtful, particularly if you're going through a tough time and people want to pile on. And I'm just tell my celebrities, don't read it. Get people to read it for you. Get block the nastiest one. If there's anything actionable, I mean, I've had clients get death threats and threats of violence.
And those can be very scary as well, because we've seen instances where celebrities have been hurt and sometimes worse.
Well, we've had celebrities murdered. You know, you look at John Lennon, you look at others, and that was before social media, certainly. But yes, I take it seriously. I've had death threats. I've gone to the police. My clients have had death threats. And you do. But you also have to understand, even the average person, we live in a world where we all have a public image. You're on social media, you're on Twitter or Facebook. And there's ways to protect yourself there, particularly on Facebook. You can read what people are posting about you. If you think it's malicious, delete what they say and block the person. There's no shame in doing that. If it's something that's quote unquote actionable and violates the terms of service, let Facebook know. And you can control Facebook. On the upper right corner, you'll see different control panels, and you should not let people post on your page. You should control the posts on your page.
You know, and Twitter has changed the rules of the game here, because anybody can follow you unless your account is private. But I mean, if you're a journalist or if you're in any way in the public domain, you know, it makes no sense to close your account to the public. You want to be followed by as many people. And I remember in the early days, if ever there was a negative tweet directed at me, it would bother me. And now it just doesn't bother me anymore. As you said, I think just develop a thick skin and just accept that that's part of the sort of public conversation. I mean, is that also advice you would give your clients?
Oh, absolutely. And realize who most of these idiots are who are doing this. They're these losers who don't have a job, or they're delivering pizzas, and they're in, you know, the basement of their parents' house because they can't afford their own apartment, and their dirty boxer shorts, you know, going, oh, I'll go after this celebrity. When people like you and I stand up here, we put our opinions out, perhaps, but we put our names attached to them. We take responsibility, and so we become targets. You know, I tell people, we live in this world where I call it the feedback society. Mm-hmm. Everybody's got an opinion, and everybody thinks we care about their opinion. And I tell people, you could cure cancer tomorrow. 15% of the people will criticize you and go, oh my God, you've put the nurses and the pharmaceutical companies and the oncologists out of business. How horrible that you cured cancer. And you just have to accept this is the world we live in now.
Right. Howard Bragman, thanks very much. The founder of 15 Minutes, and also with Reputation.com.